Welcome to your very first video lecture for your Anatomy and Physiology 1 lab. I am Anna Galletly, and I'm going to be talking about the orientation, terminology, directional terminology, etc. In this lecture.
On this slide, we're going to look at probably one of the most important concepts in anatomy and physiology. You have to have this, and that is anatomical position. All right. So what you want to remember is that you are looking at the front of a person's body. It doesn't matter who it is, but you always describe the person's body as the front. The palms are forward. The thumbs are out to the side or lateral. Your feet, the feet are going to be as if they're flat on the ground. It doesn't matter if this person is in fetal position or standing on their head or floating in outer space. When you describe them as if they are in anatomical position. And remember, you always use the patient or the cadaver's right and left. You don't use your right and left to do the description. All right, next we're going to start talking about the orientation terminology. You never use terms like up, down, front, back when you're discussing anatomy and physiology, because what that means to one person changes with another person. It's inconsistent. When you use words like that, that's how when someone goes into surgery, instead of having their right foot cut off, they get their left foot cut off. Right? They're dangerous. So don't use them. We want to use proper orientation terminology. So first of all, you've got your body right here. We want to talk about what you would like to call front and back, but I don't want you to use front and back for anything in this course. I want you to use anterior and posterior. So anterior is going to be anything that's towards the front of the body. So that is anterior. Posterior is going to be anything towards the back of the body, on the back surface, on the posterior surface, the rear end, that sort of thing. Okay. Now, we have some terminology that is that was adapted from talking about four-legged animals. So that would be ventral and dorsal. So ventral is synonymous with anterior, whereas dorsal is synonymous with posterior. When I think of the word ventral and dorsal, I try to think of like a fish, all right? So let's see if I can draw a fish without making you laugh, all right? So here we've got a fish or a shark, all right? They've always got a fin, all right? That is their dorsal fin. So when I try to remember the difference between dorsal and ventral, I imagine a fin on the back, and that tells me that is dorsal, okay? And then anterior, the synonym is ventral, okay? Now, notice these examples right here. They're not just doing something like saying the aorta is ventral or the esophagus is posterior, because that doesn't make any sense. When you're using these orientation terms, you're using them in relationship to other structures in the body. So the aorta is ventral to the vertebral column. The esophagus is posterior to the trachea, whereas the esophagus might be anterior to the vertebrae, okay? So how you use the term changes depending on what two structures you are comparing it to. All right, let's look at the next slide. All right, so now we're going to look at superior and inferior. Superior is when you're going towards the head. Inferior is when you're going towards the feet, okay? Now, again, in four-legged animals, so if you have a dog or a cat, all right, there's their legs, here's their really funny tail, all right, this would be ventral. And this would be dorsal, okay? Now they've got a head, and another word for head is cephalic, all right? And here is their tail, and another word for tail is caudal. So when we talk about these creatures, we might use things like cephalic and caudal to talk about the orientation on their body. However, in humans, it doesn't make any sense because we have two legs. All right. To say if it's towards your tail, well, the tail is basically there on the posterior side of your body. That doesn't really make sense. It's weird. Okay. So we typically use superior, inferior to describe things going towards the head instead of saying cephalic. We typically use the word inferior to describe things going towards the feet instead of saying caudal, because technically caudal would end right there at your butt. And that's just weird. So, every once in a while, we'll talk about those words in different parts of the body, things that are like common conventions, but typically we use superior, inferior, anterior, posterior. And again, focus on the to the part of the sentence when we're using these examples. The spinal cord is caudal to the brain, or let's actually switch that to a better word, inferior to the brain. Okay. And let's say the heart is superior to the diaphragm, but it would be inferior to the throat. Okay. So again, this relationship between two structures is really important when you're using your orientation terminology. All right, next set of terms, medial and lateral. These are fun to play with. So medial is talking about your midline. So the word medial, all right, you're focusing on that M right there, all right, middle or midline, anything towards the midline. So like, if you're looking at your chest right here, it is medial to your arm, okay? But again, if you change the terminology, you have to change what you're doing. So lateral, you're going away from the midline. So this chest, okay, it is medial to the arm. Let's put it in the arm. But the chest is going to be lateral to the sternum. And actually, let's change that around. Whoops, wrong word, wrong thing. Eraser, there's my eraser. Let's say, let's be more specific. Let's say the left breast. Okay. All right, does that make sense? So that is, the left breast is medial to the arm, but the left breast is lateral to the sternum. Okay, so lateral is away, medial is toward the midline. You need to practice using these terms. All right, now we're going to look at probably the most complicated terms for people with practicing. When we use proximal distal, you only use it with the arms and legs. Right, and I'm going to insist that you use it in this lab. To the point where if I'm asking you to describe orientation on the arms and legs and you use superior and inferior, I'm not going to give you full credit on quizzes and tests. You have to use proximal and distal on all tests and quizzes, okay? They are important, and if you don't know them, you're going to let somebody cut off the wrong arm or leg or foot or toe or whatever. They are important. So the word proximal, if you look at it, it looks really similar to in proximity, all right? And if you are in proximity to something, you are close to it. In contrast, distal looks like the word distant. So if you are distal, you are far away or further away or going away from something, okay? So these words are used to describe the arms and legs compared to the torso, okay? So if you are getting closer to the torso, you are getting proximal, all right? If you're going away from the torso, you are more distal. Okay, so if we look at these terms, I have my elbow right here. Oops, I want this elbow right there. My elbow is going to be proximal to the wrist, but it is going to be distal to the shoulder. So that's the example right here. The elbow is proximal to the wrist, but the elbow is distal to the shoulder. And remember, when we're using these orientation terms, we are describing one body part in relationship to another. Okay? Now on this slide, we also have ipsilateral and contralateral. So I want you to look at the word contra. That's probably the easiest one to start with. Contra means opposite or against. Okay? So if something is contralateral, it's on the opposite side of the body. So you see this example, the spleen is contralateral to the liver, which means here is my liver, there's my liver, and there is my spleen. So the spleen is on the opposite side of the body in comparison to the liver, so it is contralateral to the liver. On the other hand, ipsi means the same. Oops, this is getting kind of cluttered. Right there, same. Okay, so if it's ipsilateral, it's on the same side. So over here, my example with the liver, the appendix right here is on the same side of the body as the liver. So it is ipsilateral to the liver. The liver and the appendix are ipsilateral. They're on the same side of the body. All right, next slide. All right, so on this slide, you're getting some definitions for the cephalic, the rostral, the caudal. Again, I'm not going to focus on those. I want to focus on superficial and deep. So if something is superficial, all right, it's getting closer to the surface. So you see how surface and superficial sound similar, okay? Where deep, you're going deep. Like if you're digging deep into the ground, you're getting, you know, you're going further in. And we use this to describe how we dig into a body. So if something is closer to the surface of the body, it's superficial. If something is deeper, it's deeper into the body. So if you are looking at your intestines are going to be deep to the muscle of the belly, okay? But the intestines are, actually intestines aren't a great example. Let's start with muscles. So the muscles, the abdominal muscles, all right? They are going to be deep to skin, okay, because they're deeper in, but they are going to be superficial to the intestines. Okay? All right, next slide. All right, this slide has two pictures, and on your own, what I want you to do is take a pen or a pencil and draw and find these things on your structures. So for example, nasal is gonna go to nose, oral is gonna go to mouth, frontal is gonna go to forehead. Okay, so you're gonna go through and do all of that on your own. When we are describing the body, we often talk about cutting it into different planes or sections. Okay? So these terms are typically named after something in the body that makes it a little bit easier to look at. So frontal is talking about the bone, and coronal is talking about the coronal suture. In a lot of the anatomy and medical books, you see the word frontal plane used most of the time, but if you're going into osteology orthopedics, they might use the coronal suture because that's commonly used with people who do more stuff with bones, okay? And basically what this does is it cuts the body into front, back, okay? But remember, I don't want you to use those terms. I want you to use, oops, that's the wrong word. I want you to use anterior, posterior instead. Okay, so if you see here, it's cutting this off. So if you cut her nose off, you're cutting it off in the frontal or coronal plane. Oop, there goes an R there. Okay, now the sagittal plane, and that should be an L on the end, not there. Okay, sagittal plane is instead doing right, left, or medial, lateral. Okay, and you can see it's right here. right? So if you cut someone's arm off right here, you are cutting it in the sagittal plane. If you sliced an ear off, you would be slicing it off in the sagittal plane. All right, transverse section, that is doing a superior inferior cut or a proximal distal cut. Let's change colors. So that's right here, okay? So if you amputate someone's leg right there, you are doing it in a transverse plane. If you're watching or reading a lot of graphic novels and you see someone cut in half right across there, again, transverse plane. Next slide. All right, I find this slide really fun because it shows you how you are cutting the body up into different planes. This is a really common section that we see in our anatomy books because we can see what the structures look like in the body. And you've basically cut it right down the midline and you've got a right left. So we are actually looking at the right side of her body. The left side is gone and you can see what the organs look like in there. Now, the frontal section, remember, is doing an anterior posterior cut. So we've basically cut through, taken the entire front of the body off, and now you can see what the lungs look like and the heart looks like when you cut the front off. And then again, a very common section is also the transverse section. You see a lot of CTs and MRIs, and you basically are cutting down. So if you've got someone's head right here, need a nose, and they're basically doing slices like this, and they're cutting the tops off. So I kind of think of this as the Kill Bill cut, and you basically slice off sections, okay? And that was the last of the slides in this particular video lecture. So you can go back and review this at will and then continue on to the next topic, which I believe is body cavities.